What is so great about Bidhan Chandra Roy that we celebrate Doctors' Day? You know, every country doesn't have the same person on the same day for commemorating doctors. Every continent, every country has a different date associating with their own physicians. We celebrate it not because of life, because we have selected Dr. B.C. Roy as the person that we want to remember. Now we have to see what is so great about this planet, that we every year celebrate Doctor's Day on his birthday. Because Doctor's Day is not from independence, it's only from the 70s. Bidhan Chandra Roy died in 62, at the age of 80 years. There were a lot of other doctors at that time. If you take the south, we had Lakshman Swami Mudaliar. We had Dr. P. Ramamurthy. We had Stanley John in Willow. All 90s. If you go to the east, you had Ranjit Raj Chaudhary. You had A.K. Basu. People who have made tremendous contributions to medicine. You go to the north, you had K.L.D. You had P. N. Chudani. So many people. You go to the west, of course, you had Rustam Rocky. You had Parankar and all people who have made tremendous contributions to medicine. So why did they select B.C. Roy of all people to commemorate doctors? So let us look at this life and see what made them unique, that the government thought that amongst all these people who are available, they should select B.C. Roy's birthday for Doctors' Day here. And I recount whatever I remember from memory, because I didn't come prepared to speak. He lived 80 years. He died on the day he was born. Is that why he was selected? Because 1st July he was born and 1st July he died. I don't know many other people who have had a birthday and death
day.
Death have the safety. Obviously, it couldn't be due to that. He was one of the early, but not the earliest to do medicine in India. He did in Calcutta what was called the Campbell Medical School those days. Later became the Calcutta Medical College. So many people did medicine. It couldn't be that. Is it because he went abroad and acquired further qualification? If you see at the turn of the independence, so many people went abroad before and after. But what was unique about them was their motive. Every Indian who went to UK or anywhere for training, the intention was to come back and serve the country, not the intention that is there in the mind of people today. You take Ramanujan, unfortunately he died before he could come back and serve. You take Srinivasa Shastri, you take Jawaharlal Nehru. All of them went for education, but to come back and serve. B.C. Roy also went, not to stay there, got a job offer there, but to come back and serve. He was an outstanding student, and he wanted to do his post-graduation in St. Bart's Hospital. He had to apply 30 times to be accepted. 29 times he was rejected, but he had the persistence to apply. He said, I want to do this. And he ultimately got selected. They got so fed up of his application, said, all right, come finish it, go. He did both MRCP and FRCs. Because somebody asked him, why did you do this? He said, I want to provide comprehensive care to my people. I don't think my people can be referred from one person to another. So I should be able to give them all-round advice. One of the very few people who had got membership of the Royal College of Physicians and also fellowship of the Royal College of Science. I know only one other man who did that. And he was my teacher called Samiran Nandi when I was an Olympian student. He had MRCP and MRCS. I asked him, why did you do this? What made you do both? But his answer was different from B.C. Sivan. He said, Ananthakrishnan, look, when you go to interviews, there are lots of idiots appearing for the interview. You want to appear different from other idiots. Therefore, they should ask you this question and give you a chance to talk. But B.C. Roy had both MRCP and FRCS because he wanted to provide comprehensive care. He came back joined the service, government service, also started practice. But his practice was not confined to poor people initially, it was sort of rich clientele. Bengal had a lot of intellectuals in the post-freedom or the pre-freedom era. And poor people formed only part of his clientele. He never thought that he should devote his life only to the care of the poor. Till the Gandhi's fast came in Bengal, and Gandhiji was fasting, and B.C. Roy was selected to go and meet him. Those of you who have seen the movie Gandhi, remember this episode in that movie. When there are riots, a lot of killing and going on, and he's fasting, and how that fast comes to an end. So, B.C. Roy went to treat Gandhi, and Gandhi said, don't come near me. Why? You want to treat me? You treat all my 400 million countrymen free? You take money from them. So why should I take treatment from them? That day he decided that he will devote his evenings only to the care of the poor. From that day, till the day he died, even after he became the Minister of Bengal, he was seeing poor patients in his clinic for 1 hour every day. There are many things about him like this, very interesting personality and his contribution to the National Fund. He wrote about globalization 50 years before globalization happened. Now you realize, out of all the people available, why government chose B.C. Roy to be the man whose life is celebrated because of many people that they come across. Occasionally they find one who leaves footsteps in his hands of time, where they feel that they are lucky to have lived during their lifetime. It's another issue these days that the highest national award for physicians is named after him. And last year it was given to a person whose house was raided by income tax 1 week after the award. Exactly 1 week after the award, it was raided. That is how national awards are given. I wonder sometimes whether celebrating B.C. Roy as a doctor's day and inserting his memory, because in his name so many things are happening. But why I am telling you this is only 1 week. His life is his message, his life is the advice. So if you remember his contribution to the country, to the freedom struggle, to the care of the patient, and the devotion with which he managed the sick people, particularly those who couldn't pay, I don't think we need to say anything more about doctors. They are like a ceremony. So I think it is appropriate to remember today B.C. Roy, Vidhan Dada as he was called, and feel happy and proud that in this country we have chosen B.C. Roy to celebrate the doctors. Thank you very much.